Hey everybody, welcome back again to Ken Tamplin Vocal Academy, where the proof is in the singing. I'm continuing my series on taking these absolutely incredible isolated vocal tracks. I'm giving you a singing lesson. I'm talking about the band, sort of the backstory of the band, some production tips on how all this stuff was put together, a little backstory of the band, etc. Next up is Johnny Cash, and the song is called Hurt. But before we get started, if you wouldn't mind, please like and subscribe to my channel. That'd be really cool. I actually I'm coming up on a million subs, and I'd love to get there really soon, guys. So if you wouldn't mind, hit that like button. Don't forget to ring the bell. That would be great. I also have a singing course, and this isn't just a quick statement. I got the singing course. No, I have this like crazy great singing course for you guys out there that want to learn how to sing. You can find it right here at kentamplinvocalacademy.com, and the course is called How to Sing Better Than Anyone Else. I also have a free singing form over there for you guys also interested in just kind of getting your feet wet to see if singing's right for you or if you're interested in vocals, okay? Now, with that said, this particular video, and this video here, but the song is absolutely incredible, and I mean absolutely incredible. Let me explain. Now, I was never a big Johnny Cash fan growing up, confessedly. However, because I was an 80s, 70s, 80s metal rock guy, 90s, whatever. So I never really appreciated Johnny for the quintessential example of a great storyteller. Growing up, yes, I was aware of Folsom Prison Blues, and I was aware of, all the early Johnny, Boy Named Sue, and there were funny songs and crazy stuff that he did. But I always thought of that as like something your parents listened to or some country bumpkin listened to. It just wasn't for me until later in life that I realized the genius of his songwriting craft and his storytelling. And I do mean, next to Willie Nelson and some others, like the ultimate storyteller, okay? Now, I'm going to get to that in a minute, but I want to prelude a lot of this. With the person that actually produced the song, and his name is Rick Rubin. Now, love him or hate him, I've heard lots of both sides of the coin on this. Rick has produced some absolutely incredible things. Let me give you an example. One of the things that Rick was good at was really odd marriages of different artists. So, for example, Rick was the one that put together Aerosmith with the rap band Run DMC for Walk This Way. Now, if that's too before your time and you don't remember, please look it up. But Aerosmith's career, to be candid, was kind of, just on the skids and on its way out. Run DMC was a rap band. I think Rick was working with them at the time. I know John Klodner helped put the deal together, if I'm not mistaken. But anyway, he made this marriage of, two guys in a rehearsal room, and there was, there was Aerosmith in the one rehearsal room, Run DMC in the other, and they both hated their music, and then they bashed in through the wall. And then all of a sudden, there was a synergy between the two groups, and then the rest is history, and it resuscitated Aerosmith's career. So for you newer guys out there, you may not even know who Aerosmith was or is had it not been for that video, had it not been for Rick Rubin making this marriage, okay? Now, I know he did other things like the Bangles, Hazy Shade of Winter did a great job and stuff like that. But this brother, by the way, look him up, Rick Rubin. You can just do a quick search, what songs has Rick Rubin produced? And I'm gonna get to Johnny Cash in a second because this is important. But I wanna talk about the video and some other stuff. There's some intrigue for me. I know it's a long prelude to this, but guys, hang in there. I think if you're interested, I think it'll really be worth your time. So, you've got Slayer and Danzig, some of the people that Rick's produced. from that to Tom Petty. You've got, like I said, Run DMC. You've got, other hip hop, Eminem, Red Hot Chili Peppers. I mean, I could go on and on in this list. Metallica, Neil Diamond, Tom York, Weezer, just Linkin Park, And so his spectrum of the amount and diversity of people that he's produced is literally off the charts, music charts. But not the least of which is this song here, which is Hurt. Now, for you guys that are in the know, you know that this song is a Trent Reznor song from Nine Inch Nails. So Trent originally did it, and Rick got Johnny Cash to do it later in life, just before he died. Now, I want to talk about the video for a second, and then I'm going to get into the song and the lyrical content and Johnny Cash as a great storyteller. So the video is literally, and I mean literally, maybe the most moving music video I've ever seen in my life. And that is not an understatement. Watch it. Johnny Cash Hurt, okay? It kind of depicts his whole life, And he was known, yeah, I dressed appropriately for him today. He was known as the man in black, you know, the original Bad A. He was known as, you know, you just don't mess around with Johnny. He would go to prisons and do these, you know, crazy concerts and stuff, record them live. So you can look up some of that stuff. But he was also had a major conversion to Christianity. Now, I'm not here to promote all that. I'm just making a point that someone that had been so, you know, degenerate and so, you know, such a Bad A, right? From one side to make such a bold statement of faith on the other side in another direction. Now, he married June Carter Cash, I meant to say, thank you. And, you know, divorced his first wife and it was a big mess. But anyway, and then went on to, you know, to do some hits like Ring of Fire and some cool stuff that we remember later. But I say this because when you watch the video, it is so prescient and so emotionally deeply moving. It's sort of laid out like the Lord's Supper, but in a really macabre kind of way. And he's reflecting back on his whole life. And the whole song is about, I poke myself today just to see if I could feel, you know, you gotta know the song. We're gonna get into the lyric in a minute, so I don't have a spoiler alert for that. But I say that because when you combine the video with the lyric of this, and I did do a reaction to this a while back, but I'm actually going to dissect and get down and dirty into his storytelling techniques. But so Rick Rubin grabbing Trent Reznor from Nine Inch Nails, marrying that to Johnny Cash, and putting this together in a synergy that is just off the charts amazing. So let's get started, Johnny. Whoops, sorry, this was not an input. So I'm going to play the instrumentation right up to, in fact, I'll just roll right up to the vocal and mute the instrumentation. Here we go.
I hurt myself today to see if I still feel. I focus on the pain.
Cool. Now, if you were cursorily going through this and just superficially saying, oh, you know, this is like old guy singing about what, you know, I hurt myself today, you know, I poked myself, you know, just to see if I could feel, etc. And you didn't recognize the backstory and see this video, you'd be thinking, okay, well, Ken, like, why is this so great? Well, I want you for a minute to think about something. First of all, this is Johnny Cash, one of the greatest, you know, country storytellers of all time. And he's reflecting back on his life and what mattered and what didn't matter. And this is really important because here's a guy that was at the top of the world for a really long time. And he's going back and he's reflecting back on his whole life. Okay. It's a retrospective. So he's going back in his whole life and he's going, okay, what could I have changed? What was good? What was bad? And he's at this Passover table, like the Passover of Christ, you know, and he's going through the elements, you know, of Passover. And so he's directly relating all of the incidences of his life and being sort of at his last meal, like a last supper, right? Because I think he knows he's going to die. I think he died a few months after this video was made. I think this was one of the last things he ever did. And so I also think that's why Rick wanted to do a time capsule of him too, to make sure that he didn't leave us before he got a chance to say what he wanted to say. And with a view towards that now, listen to the lyric and listen to the way he chillingly, hauntingly sings it. Check it out.
I hurt myself today to see if I still feel. I focus on the pain, the only thing that's real.
Wow, right? In other words, you go through life and you could have the whole world handed to you on a platter, and you could have all the parties, and I think of Frank Sinatra, and, you know, I did it my way, and all this kind of stuff. And I think of this him saying, you know, he lost his wife and his family and this and that, and there was nothing left. And you see this in the video. And then he's talking about how the only thing that seems real to him, because he's so numb, right, is that the hurt and the pain is the only thing that he can really relate to that lets him know that he's still alive and that what, you know, again, with this depiction of what his life was about. Now, I want to put in the music because the music is also very dark. And it builds and builds and builds into just a chilling ending. And again, I'm going to put this in the description, guys. So you go into the description and look at the video of this and tell me if this doesn't absolutely, literally put it in your top 2, 3, 4, 5 of one of the most emotionally moving videos that you'll probably ever see. Here he goes with the music.
I hurt myself today to see if I still feel. I focus on the pain, the only thing that's real. The needle tears the hole, the old familiar sting. Try to kill it all away, but I remember everything.
Okay, so it's interesting because he's relating, obviously it's a drug, a needle, this, that, heroin, whatever. And I know, again, it's a Trent Reznor song. So let's keep that in mind. Trent talking about, you know, himself in this sort of way, right? But Johnny Cash is in his own way, is taking, not the word idiom, but he's taking the concept of anesthetizing himself, that the pain of this, you know, drug or whatever it is that's going to numb him to the point that the only thing he still feels or that's left in his life is pain, and he's looking to sort of rid himself of that with this numbing effect of this drug, so to speak. However, there's such a familiarity to it that it's become his friend in a sense. This pain has become a friend, and yet the again, the anesthetization, is that a word, of the concept of this. Now the interesting too is that it's just an acoustic all the way up to this point. Very kind of, you know, non-plussing, non-descriptive acoustic. I know there's a tiny piano stab in there, and it gets more and more and more momentous as we go. But I just am pointing that out too, that it's not a bunch of production and fireworks and this and that, or, you know, a lot of these goth videos where everyone's stabbing somebody and the child in the coffin, or, you know, the spouse that's dead in the coffin, and all these kind of things. Like, and there's so many people that play off of that. That's more of like a movie. I don't know. I don't want to like belittle other people's art or whatever, so that's maybe not the best thing to do. But it doesn't matter if it's Sam Smith walking into, you know, a funeral procession and his lover's in a coffin or whatever, and some people think that's one of the most moving videos they've ever seen. Okay, that's their prerogative. But this is more like looking back on life and how someone that's reached this level of success is able to look at this and then tell you, hey, let me tell you about my life and what is important and what isn't. So I think that's a big difference for me as a songwriter too. So let's continue. Here we go. Just the lyric.
What have I become? My sweetest friend. Everyone I know goes away in the end. And you could have it all, my empire of dirt. I will let you down. I will make you hurt.
Now, if you notice the intensity of his voice, when I talk about Johnny Cash being the ultimate storyteller, and you listen to this, and as the music builds and the emotion, he's like practically crying out his words. I kid you not. He's like slitting both wrists and bleeding out what he's saying. I want to pop in the music again. I want to listen to this again. And I want you to pay attention to the intensity. And again, I wish I had the video as a backdrop for this, because it literally make you cry. But he's talking about losing everybody in his life that he's ever known. And that he, as hard as he's tried, he's fallen short of being the great guy that maybe he'd hoped he would be. And that if you were with him, you know, as much as he'd love to tell you he's going to be your lover, your friend, your father, your, you know, your best guy, whatever, that he's just going to make you hurt. Okay, so now check it out. Listen.
What have I become? My sweetest friend. Everyone I know goes away in the end. And you could have
of a sudden, there's I will make it. And then we drop back down into the setup for yet another verse. But the emotional intensity is really insane. It's really good. And when you think about people that just randomly sing them, if I say to you, you know, what have I become? I will make you hurt, right? And you heard me do it, you go, okay, well, I don't know, it's kind of cool. But if I, what have I become? My sweetest friend, I will make you hurt, right? You get that emotion out of this song. It's wild, his ability to tell the story. Let's continue. Let's move on. I'm not trying to make too much out of this, guys. I really mean it, man. And by the way, I'm pretty careful about things I praise and things I, you know, if it's something I don't like, I just don't talk about it, right? But anyway, let's continue. Here we go.
I wear this crown of thorns.
Crown of thorns.
Upon my liar's chair. Full of broken thoughts, I cannot repair.
Okay. Now, even though he's got, you know, some dysphonia and he's got almost like spasmodic dysphonia where he's losing control of his faculties, of his ability to sing and tell a story, he's never been an awesome singer. He's just been a great storyteller. It's the maturity of his voice that's also really interesting, like grandpa in the fireplace telling a story of his life, you know, you better listen to me kind of thing, right? Really cool.
Beneath the stains of time.
Good lyric.
The feelings disappear. You are someone else. I am still right here.
So in other words, people go on with their lives and he's left with what he contributed to life. And he's left with his hurt, his pain, his lying, his cheating, his being the big bad boy guy, all these different things, his divorce, his, you know, losing loved ones, and. By the way, life isn't always all this negative. I'm not trying to make life be so dark and dismal, but I'm just pointing out that as he's reflecting back over all this stuff, he's saying, I'm the total sum of the choices that I've made. And that is really crazy. Like when you really think about, okay, who I am and this later in life, I'm the total sum and I am totally guilty and I'm totally responsible and I have to take, you know, credit or, you know, take account or take ownership, I should say, of the total sum of who I've become. And he's relating that story here. And that's just downright amazing to me. So,
what have I become, my sweetest friend? Everyone I know goes away in the end. And you could have it all, my empire of dirt. I will let you down. I will make you hurt.
Now, it's interesting too, some of the imagery that's used, and I know Trent did a fantastic job in the songwriting of this. He's just amplifying it more, I believe, in Johnny's case because of his storytelling. But you can have it all, this empire of dirt. He's not saying, you know, I've got yachts and cars or, you know, whatever, I'm not all this materialism. You know, he's saying he's counting and using a term like empire and dirt in the same word. So in other words, he's got it all, but he's equating it to dirt, right? And in the end, and maybe even some references to being 6 feet under, if you know what I mean, like there's a lot of imagery here that's really fascinating. Let's continue here. Pretty good stuff.
If I could start again.
If I could start again.
A million miles away. I would keep myself. I would find away.
So he's saying if he could reflect back over his whole life and do it all over again, he talks about living a different life and making a different kind of difference. Now I want to play this back with where it gets intense with the music, so you can hear how this plays into what Rick Rubin did a fantastic job in taking something so simple and instrumentation so simple and creating this emotive craziness. Check it out.
What have I become? My sweetest friend. Everyone I know goes away in the end. And you could have it all. My empire of dirt. I will let you down. If I could start again, a million miles away, I would keep myself, I would find a way.
Wow. And then he died shortly thereafter. After he left you his epitaph or his legacy of explaining his life, what he's gone through, and what he would hope you would look at, I believe, as his swan song a retrospective look over his whole life. So anyway, this to me was one of the most prescient, moving, fantastic video marriages that Rick Rubin has done to date, I believe. I have a lot more of these coming your way. So please stick around for that. If you're interested in singing, again, check out my singing course and definitely check out my next video.